The lesson is devoted to cluster, skeleton, edge net, and ring net simplifications. It should be noted that our video lessons don't answer the question which simplification method you should use for topological analysis. To answer the question, you should watch our webinars on the site scdms.ru. Our lesson describes the main ToposPro commands and shows how to use different simplification methods. So, I select the compound, run ADS, Options tab command, and mark Option Save Simplified Net, and choose Cluster Simplification Method. ToposPro offers to create new database for the simplified structure. I use code 1. Now I should select central atoms. In this case, we have to select all atoms because the program must consider the whole structure to simplify it. So I select all atoms. We have new database with the same name but with suffix C. This command means that all rings with size 6 and less are intracluster, with size 7 and more intercluster. We can see that all intercluster valence bonds were changed to pseudohydrogen bonds. Now we should perform standard simplification for molecular parking connected by hydrogen bonds. If you don't know how to do it in details, see our lesson devoted to standard simplification. So I run ADS options, save simplified net, standard method. Tap topology valence bonds, connect atoms, hydrogen molecules. Run central atoms, whole molecule. We have simplified the structure, and before classification, I have to delete all 0, 1, and 2 coordinated nodes. I open compound, auto-determine, simplified adjacency matrix, remove all 0, 1, and 2 coordinated nodes. Now I can classify it. I click ADS, Options, Topology, Default. This button sets the options for classification on the underlying net of the crystal structure. ToposPro offers to load the TTD collection, which is necessary for classification. Now we can see the topological type of structure. It has BCU topology. A modification of the cluster simplification is the skeleton simplification. In this case, we should specify the maximal size of rings that will be accounted to determine the atoms belonging to the structure skeleton. Atoms belonging to small rings are removed from the structure and the small rings are replaced by edges of the simplified skeleton net. Let's look at the structure. As you can see, it has 5 and 6 membered rings. Let's transform 5 membered rings to edges. I run ADS, Options, Save Simplified Net, Simplification Method, Skeleton. Here we should specify maximal size of rings. I will use 5. Now we have the simplified structure. As you can see, all 5 membered rings were transformed to edges. 6 membered rings were not changed. This representation is especially useful when analyzing entanglements, since in this case, small rings, being impossible to be catenated, just hinder the topological analysis. Special structure representation is EdgeNet. EdgeNet can be constructed by placing new nodes in the midpoints of the edges of the initial net, connecting new nodes by new edges, and removing old nodes and edges. For example, we take the net GIS, it has one 4-coordinated node, open ADS, Options, Save Simplified Net, Simplification Method, Edge Net, Run. Now we have simplified net. As you can see, it has 2 6-coordinated nodes. We can determine its topology. ADS, Options. We can use button default. It gives standard options for classification of the crystal structure. I choose all atoms as central. As you can see, the net has the GISE topology. A special kind of ring net is hop-ring net. That is the net whose nodes and edges correspond to rings and hop-flings between them. Hop-ring directly characterizes the catenation pattern. For more information about hop-ring nets, see our webinars Entanglements in Coordination Polymers, Analysis and Classification by Topological Methods, on the website sctms.ru. Let's see how to construct hop-ring. Let's look at the structure. As you can see, it is rather complicated 3D metal organic framework. At first, I should do the standard simplification for the structure. So I run ADS, Options, Save Simplified Net, Simplification Method Standard, Run. Since it is metal complexes, as central atoms, I should choose metal atoms. We have 5 different nodes, but we should delete all 0, 1, and 2 coordinated nodes. So I open Compound, Order Determine, Simplified Adjacency Matrix, remove all 0, 1, and 2 coordinated nodes. Now we have only 4 coordinated nodes. We can look at the structure. Now we should construct the hop-free net. I run ADS, Options, Save Simplified Net, Simplification Method Ring Net. Now I open tab Topology and check option Entanglement. If maximum ring will be 0, Topos will look for entanglement between cycles. If we set maximum ring option, Topos will look for entanglement between rings of the given size or smaller. When you specify maximum ring size, you should set the biggest ring in the structure. Of course, you don't know exactly the size of the rings, so better set maximum ring equals to 10-12, because it is enough to the most of structures. You should remember, the larger the maximum ring is, the slower calculation will be. If we set option maximum ring sum, Topos will look for entanglement between strong rings. For more information about entanglements, you should watch our webinar Entanglements in Coordination Polymers, Analysis and Classification by Topological Methods. We have a new database with the simplified crystal structure. As you can see, the structure has pseudocarbon atoms bonded by valence and hydrogen bonds. Carbon atoms coincide with the centers of rings, valence bonds correspond to the edges shared by rings, hydrogen bonds correspond to the hop flings. Let's look at the structure. Here we can see The net whose nodes and edges correspond to rings and hop links between them. We may analyze the structure taking into account valence or hydrogen bonds. For example, I will determine the topology taking into account only valence bonds. ADS, options default button, as you can see, it has SQL topology. This is the topology of the ring net of one of the catenated nets in the initial structure. The same procedure can be made for hydrogen bonds. ADS, options, topology, valence bonds none, hydrogen bonds atoms. This net has DIA topology. This is the topology of catenation. At last, we can consider both bonds type, ADS, options, topology, valence bonds connect atoms, hydrogen bonds connect atoms. Now we have the 8D34 topology. This is the topology of the whole catenated array of nets. So, we have considered different types of simplification. For more information about possibilities of the program package ToposPro, watch our lessons and webinars on the website sctms.ru.